Well, I'm sorry I said that. Bottom line, but like I said, we get on attack mode. And that's when they say, look, we're going to do it so we can get back at them. But you just have to bring it softly. Bring it softly. Okay? But now, you finish that?
Verse 11.
Go ahead.
But the Lord is with me as a mighty, terrible one. Mm-hmm. Therefore, my persecutor shall stumble.
So you say he ain't worried about it because those that are going to come after him, the Lord fights his battle. And those that persecute him shall be a stumble. And if we have people stumbling right now because they don't like the name Jesus. And the book say they was going to stumble at the Lord.
Right.
And the biggest one they stumble at is his name. Mm-hmm. You know, we understand the Lord got, you know, different names. He's called a rock. He's called I am. He's called a savior. But you say you understand Hebrew and you ain't been in no Hebrew land since you was born. But you know how to, you know, pronounce certain, you know, Hebrew texts. Come on now. Let's not get overbearing with that. If you say some things was added, some things was taken out, you know what? We ain't going to get into that today. Bottom line is we just going to see how we're supposed to come at one another. Plain and simple. Okay. But now, you finish that?
Middle of 11.
Go ahead.
And they shall not prevail.
Mm-hmm.
They shall be greatly ashamed.
And that's what happens. When you bring slander against somebody or you lie on somebody, it's going to come back to you because you reap what you sow. You bring out something, it's going to come back to you. You throw a rock, the rock might come back to you. Because you did it in an evil way, so the Lord makes sure you're going to pay. And it's going to come back sometimes sevenfold worse than it was when you dished it out. Because you started it, the Lord going to finish it. Plain and simple. Okay, but go ahead.
For they shall not prosper.
Mm-hmm.
Their everlasting confusion shall never be forgotten.
You know, that's a huge statement. Everlasting confusion. Because your book say you can't reprove a scornful man because he ain't going to hear it. So he has got everlasting confusion. You show him straight scripture, he ain't going to hear it because he's so set in his ways, set on evil, set on contention, he won't listen. But then the book also say don't go and reprove a scornful man because then you'll get a blot because he going to hate you and then you're going to be talked about, and ain't nobody else gonna go back and check it. They gonna believe what he say, cause ain't nobody checking nothing out nowadays. They just ready to jump on the bandwagon and convict. And we so quick to judge. That's why I thank God the Lord took the stoning away. Cause if he didn't, it'd be few of us walking around. Down to the last person. No, I saw you sin first, and you'd be in trouble. Plain and simple. Okay. But now, you finish that?
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's go to Matthew, the 7th chapter. Matthew 7. And we're going to pick it up at verse 1. Matthew 7. And verse 1. And like I said, when I got ready to put this lesson together, I was just like, I don't think I'm going to have enough script. And you know I always run into too many. Have to start cutting. Because you want to try to point out things, but you don't want to attack nobody, but you just want to let them know how you're supposed to walk. Plain and simple. Okay, go with Matthew 7 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Judge not, that ye be not judged.
Uh-huh.
For with what judgment ye judge, mm-hmm. ye shall be judged.
So now, if you're going to judge somebody, then guess what? You're going to be judged for that same judgment. You look at a person a certain way, and you say, well, that person looks like a hooker. Guess what? You're going to be judged that same way. Somebody's going to look at you and say, you must be a hooker. You push out something, you're going to get judged on the same thing. Okay? But go ahead.
And with what measure ye meet,
mm-hmm.
ye shall be measured to you again.
So now, whatever you throw out, going to come back at you. Because you got, like I said, you got brothers going on attack mode. Then when somebody attack them, they can't take it. The old saying is you can dish it out, but you can't take it. You started the fight, but you can't finish it. So don't push it out there. It won't come back at you. Plain and simple. Okay, go ahead.
And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye?
Mm-hmm.
But considerest not the beam that is in thine own eye.
Say, now you looking at your brother, you say, you know, man, I can need to get that mote out your eye. But you walk around with a big beam in yours. Mm-hmm. He should be saying the same thing to you. Let me get that beam out of your eye. But you so far gone and so puffed up, you don't understand that you got a beam in your eye. Okay, go ahead.
Well, how wilt thou say to thy brother,
mm-hmm.
Let me pull out that mote out of thine eye, mm-hmm. and behold, a beam is in thine own eye. Mm-hmm. Thou hypocrite, first cast out the beam out of thine own eye, mm-hmm. and then shalt thou see clearly to cast out the mote out of thy brother's eye.
Get yourself straight first. Stand on what you're going to stand. Get your facts. Get all your, you know, wisdom and all the things you need to get before you can go and tackle somebody else or tell somebody else that they got a problem or tell somebody they got a misunderstanding. Make sure you straight before you can go mess with somebody else. Okay, go ahead.
That was the end of that.
Read the next one.
Verse 6.
Uh-huh.
Give not that which is holy unto the dogs. Mm-hmm. Neither cast ye your pearls before a swine.
So now, because sometimes you can give people some, try to give them some words, some understanding. They don't want to hear it. And then you find yourself in trouble. That's why I tell brothers, if you're going to go to another place, you know, in another location and deal with people, make sure you know what the exit signs are. Make sure you know how to get up out of there. Because you might cast your pearl before a swine and you might find yourself trying to get out of there and save your life. But don't think they won't hurt you today. You embarrass some of these preachers, they will come at you to the point where first it'll start off with name calling, but it don't have nothing to do with doctrine. And then it's going to escalate to something else, and then next escalate to something else, like with Stephen. Them brothers, he told them brothers the truth, broke it down to these brothers from the beginning to the present day, and they stoned him. They didn't have no proof, didn't have no nothing, but they judged him right on the spot, and they stoned him. So that's why you don't cast your pearl before swine. Okay, go ahead and finish that.
Lest they trample them under their feet, mm-hmm. and turn again and rend you.
And come at you. So be careful, because, you know, on the internet, we could be keyboard preachers, right? We think we're safe. Because we're at our house, and can't nobody mess with us, and we just going. Then you walk outside, and they waiting on you. Don't think it won't happen. Don't think it can't happen. Because there's some brothers out here with some spears on them, they will come at you. I've been threatened, and I know if other brothers walking the same way, they've been threatened, because brothers don't like to hear the truth. And when you put them down, or you put their doctrine down, they ready to fight. It's just that simple, because you done made them look bad. And if you make them look bad to their whole congregation, they upset with you. And they don't want your mouth to be open no more. They could quiet you down. If it wasn't for it on the internet, it could play over and over and over. We'd be in trouble. But they can't erase it, so that's why it's keep going over and over. Plain and simple. Okay. But now, let's go to Psalm the 7th chapter. Psalm 7. And we're going to pick it up at verse 14. Psalm 7 and verse 14. Go ahead.
Behold, he travaileth with iniquity, and hath conceived mischief.
So now, this person traveleth with iniquity. He's just a sinful person going everywhere. And he said, and he hath conceived mischief. Go ahead.
And brought forth falsehood.
And he bringing forth lies. And he traveling to do this, going all everywhere to promote his lies, promote mischief, and promote iniquity. Okay, go ahead.